se sploh premaknili, nekateri bodo prišli celo dva kroga.
Ja, zdaj, en sistem, sem sigurno postavil spedenšnji.
Ja, ja, ok, to.
A ja, ker zdaj prelaga, ali cilj je, da se prelaga iz tam samo sem, ali tudi potem nazaj?
Mišljeno je bilo od tam sem.
Če sem jaz razumel, samo enkrat, da mora biti vsak
prenik. Če imaš časovno omejitev, potem bi lahko štel število prekrat.
Ali pa štejemo, koliko hitro je kromakno. Pa imamo mi tu eno uro, pa...
Imamo interno uro in telefon in ko rečemo start, vidimo in se zapišemo to številko za vse, ne? Oziroma če so sploh vse predstavili ali ne.
Glavni kriterij je, da je lepo učinkovitost pa univerzalnost, se pravi. Zdaj, on izpredjali se super primijo.
No sej, tu je pa v bistvu, če imaš recimo 3 minute, imaš časa, da prelagaš, da preložiš, ko štartaš, začneš, pa vidiš, daj si vse končal. Zdaj, če ti bo zmanjkal za enega, boš pač porabil vse 3 minute, pa preložil in boš 4, na primer. Če si pa zelo hiter, boš pa, ne vem, v eni minuti vseh 5 preložil.
Čeprav jaz bi mogoče res umejil sem časovno, da toliko časa se poskušajo lahko, ko se bodo mogoče že pri drugem predmetu nekateri izgubili. Ampak potem bi bo mogoče mi subjektivno oceno dal, ko boš sam že videl, ali je čist enostavno papir prijel, ali se je mučil, ne, imamo mi, idemo subjektivno. Sorry.
Samo za škata.
Relativno sverzeran.
Ja, to se tudi tam trenira, če sem prav razumel, oziroma predvideva. Nisa trenirala, ampak rekel sem mi, ko sem jih malo vprašal, so rekel, da zato so pripravljeni za znanje.
Jaz sem prijavil.
Papir sem tudi jaz videl. Papir sem tudi jaz videl.
Sorry, jaz sem samo testiral na javu od sosednje.
Če se zadej, če se velik zaplet bi bil, če bi mogel za rob priti, ne? Oziroma, da bi bil mogel biti.
Ja.
Te direktne so. Kaj pa to? Ocenjujemo, ker ne sme biti prvi na roko, ne? Torej, mora biti sem snemljiva, ne? Se nastavijo, to ni pogoj. ja, vrh planski so bili tako.
Ja, ja, Uni X.
Kje je žiga? Kje je žiga?
Ja, sem.
Okay. A lahko začnemo? Ok, jaz bi začela. Zdaj, verjamem, da ste veliko truda vložili v svoj izdelek, tako da jaz mislim, da se vsi veselimo vaših predstavitev, ampak pred predstavitvami bi pa povabila Urbana, da vam demonstrira, kako pač morate, kako mora izgledati demonstracija vašega prototipa. Tako da, kar izvoli.
No, zdaj boste lepo šli po skupinah, kakor vas bomo klicali. Na začetku bomo zmerili dolžino, se pravi, če ustreza pač kriterijem, kar smo jih predpisali. Potem boste pa imeli tu dosti enostaven izziv. Imate te tri predmete, ki jih že poznate. Vse, kar morate narediti, je, da jo primete in lahko predstavite sami. Imamo pa tudi tiste dva neznana predmeta,
ker se skrivata pod našo skrivnostno škatlo. Tako da, zdaj vam bom predstavil. Eden predmet je ta škatla, ki jo ravno tako primete in premaknete. Drugi predmet pa je, ja, kako bi sploh lahko imeli MacGyver brez sponke za papir. No, lahko malo miru. Vidim, da bo sponka očitno kar izziv, glede na vaš odziv. Na začetku, ko pridete gor in izmerimo to vašo roko, imate lahko še vašo krajšo predstavitev. Poveste, kako ste naredili, kako to funkcionira. Potem, ko to opravite, pa imate še vprašanja strani žirije, tako da pojasnite določene reči in Ja, vprašanje.
Ja, 3 minute.
Skupaj za predstavitvijo?
Ne, samo za premikanje predmetov.
Še kako vprašanje? Ja, lahko poskusite, ampak po moje bojo odštevali točke za to.
Ja, tako. Lahko to naredite, ampak probali bomo, subjektivno ocenjujemo.
Še kako vprašanje?
Jaz bi odgovoril na to vprašanje. Dva izmed katerih sta enostavnost upravljanja in kvaliteta prijemanja. Ne? To ste me zapisali tudi na listih, to da stopiš na mizo in pobiraš mizo, oziroma da moraš najprej na tla vršiti in potem pobrati, definitivno vpliva na enostavnost prijemanja. Da bodo nižje točke.
Še kaj? Dobro, potem gremo pa po vrsti po skupinah.
Ne še. Ker jaz bi še rada predstavila našo žirijo, zelo na hitrca. Z nami je danes Dik Medvešček Muravec, ja, ki je alumnus društva Ves Ljubljana. Potem Luka Mali, vodja laboratorija Maker Lab, tukaj na Fakulteti za elektrotehniko. In Boreta Rifle, ki ste ga spoznali že zjutraj, ki je pa v bistvu vodja oddelka strojegradnje. Tako da zdaj pa, ja, kar zaploskajte. No, zdaj se pa začne ta glaven del, ki se boste predstavili žiriji in tudi vsem ostalim. Tako da jaz vabim prvo ekipo in to so Matchgiverji.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. We are Team Matchgiver, and I'd like to introduce our big black hand. As you can see, like, it's pretty long. We actually had some issues with that. We had to incorporate a counterweight in order to actually be balanced. And I'd like to please my assistant to demonstrate just how balanced it is. You don't actually have to use your hand. You can actually grab a bottle and have a drink or something. I don't know. And it's also very precise. We actually picked up a very small boat off the table with those claws. I mean, they look big, but they are very precise. And that's pretty much it. It's about your... about the ease of use, you can actually just close the claw with your thumb. Like, it's very easy to operate. It doesn't require much force to actually grab an object. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Can we actually demonstrate picking up objects? There you go, an apple. A water bottle, hey. And now comes the tricky part, right? Look, we are picking up a box. Oh, I would also like to point out, we incorporated some grip texture at the bottom, just so we can actually move around the object in order to move it in the right position, in order to be picked up. And the last item. This one's gonna be tricky for everyone. As you can see, it's very easy maneuverable. You can actually precisely fine-tune the angle and everything. We even have a thump, like helper or something like that. I don't know how you call it. Please give it to our judge. I mean, we are making it look easy right now. Can we all agree? I think we just set a high standard for everyone else. Good luck, guys. It's actually not that heavy, because it's made out of light styrofoam. The reason we were able to achieve such a length is because, I mean, we didn't use wood that much. Wood is quite heavy compared to the styrofoam we used. And like, yeah, it's hollow as well. And the counterweight at the back, it's only about half a kilo, something like that. So I'd say half a kilo, something like that, around 1 kilo, or more, I guess. Plus or minus 2 kilo, just kidding. I mean, if you would like to try it.
No.
Okay. Any other question?
No, not for now.
That's it?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Precej dobro, ni bilo. Zdaj pa vabim strojnike.
Thank you.
Yeah, can you please show us how do you operate the
with simple wood stick.
So actually it's just a wood stick inside and he's pulling it with two fingers.
So if I were to lift something very heavy, I would have to pull on the wood stick a lot?
No, it's quite easy. We tried with liter and half bottle and it was like a piece of cake. We also tried grabbing pencil and then writing with it, and it was very simple.
So how often do you need to change that silver tape which is grabbing the paper? How many picks can you do?
Hvala. Zdaj pa še vabim ekipo ena.
Hi, we are team Ekipa One. This is our masterpiece, Duct Tape Master 200. Why not 2000? Because the paper was too short, so. So this is our simple device. It's made completely out of wood, as you can see. So it's really maneuverable, it's really sturdy. So if you can try to move around, it's really lightweight. And it works. So we're gonna try it now, thanks.
Thank you. So one of our ideas was to make it like easily mountable. It doesn't matter if you're left-handed or right-handed, you just put it diagonally and then just switch in and it stands on your hand. So it's pretty straightforward how to use it. It's very lightweight because we only use duct tape and a lot of wood, and as you can see, the plexiglass for our name on it. The idea was to make this arm, which is made from individual parts, little small parts, to be the precise one, but as it turned out, like the bottom, I don't know, scissors, or how would I call it, are much more comfortable to pick something very small, but we were pretty happy to, you know, just make the working arm, so you can operate it with those strings also created with duct tape. Like basically we could build the whole thing with duct tape, but we decided to just use some wood or something. And as you can see, the bottom part, it's, I call it pretty elegant. So we drill through it so the strings can be easily maneuverable. And this is basically it.
We were also expecting eggs for the demonstration, so the actual padding on the arm or on the hand, it's kind of soft, so it has this plush feeling. So I think it would withstand the egg, but we're not sure, of course.
That's all. Thank you for your attention. Any questions left? Yeah, it was meant to be in reversed order, but as it turned out, yeah, as you said.
Also, one more thing. I noticed some slippage with you carrying the water bottle. Can you just carry it again?
Yeah, sure thing.
I just wonder, all the bulky parts underneath, are they necessary or like functional or?
Design feature.
Good enough.
We tried to mimic the Terminator, but it clearly didn't work out. So. Thank you.
Hvala ekipi ena. Zdaj pa vabim trdoglavce.
Hello, we are we are team Trdoglavci. This is our project. It's a dragon picker. It has an impressive length of 1 meter. And yeah, where is the measure guy? Okay. Should I put it on? Okay. Firstly, I would like to invite my assistant to give out our books about designing of this product. I hope that IT guys can open our presentation on the PowerPoint. I know. Okay. Firstly, I would like to say that the product was mostly influenced by the most important. Yeah. Why this is a dragon? You can see our dragon teeth over there. We are most proud on our patented technology called how it's called again?
Pets.
Magic pets. Those are teeth of the dragon. Those are not just for the show. Our books start the same as the representation in the designing phase of our product. We firstly analyzed all the length and the necessary thickness of the wood with the simulations. And after that, we were inspired by the most important quantity in engineering, that's a euro. We used for designing of this product only one sheet of wood and duct tape. So yeah, it weighs exactly the same as one duct tape probably. where are the pictures? And the next thing represented in the book and presentation is the functionality of this dragon picker. It's not only the picker. We firstly started with simulations. Who didn't? After that, we had a few prototypes, so we saw that the design is right. After that, we went shopping. We got one sheet of wood and one duct tape. And functions, as you can see already, it was tested by my assistants that it works like a grabber. It can be used like functional sticks for elderly people. It actually works like it has an actual handle on the top. It can be your best dragon pet. And lastly, it is extra portable. It's compact and practical. And that's it for the representation of our special tool. I think that I will pick the objects now. Okay.
Thank you.
Super, hvala za predstavitev. Zdaj pa vabam ekipo subscribe to PewDiePie. Kakšno vprašanje? A ja? Ne. Ne, čaki, gremo še enkrat za vprašanje, ja? Sem pozabila. Še enkrat ekipa ne pride sem. Pravec se vam je modil.
Oh, thank you.
We used the ropes.
Sorry, one question. Which team you are?
Subscribe to PewDiePie. Okay.
So yeah, mostly wood, some PVC tubes, rope, elastic rope here, normal rope here, and a lot of duct tape. And now I'll try to move all the objects. And we hoped for some heavy stuff to lift. I think it could lift up to 10 kilos, but obviously we have lighter objects here. Yes, in between the paper and the hand. It's styropor. We found it in garbage, so I mean we should have a little bit more time for modifications on this part of the hand. We didn't know how exactly we should solve that. So that was there because the handle was too big. Well, yeah.
Yeah.
How come did you choose the design like this to go backwards? Use it like
well, we wanted, I mean, we hoped for heavier objects that we could just load up onto this side. So you can't hold heavier objects with, you know, just two sides. So we want a strong, robust product.
Okay. So what was the original plan for those dev layers?
Well, it's a...
Was meant for something or it was just for... Nice catch because of the staple?
Like it's for some for something like that, you know?
So you had an insider?
Yeah, no. No, we didn't know what we'll have. We just mounted this, I don't know.
Okay. Zdaj pa vabim ekipo Raketa.
Works. Greetings everybody. It all started on a piece of paper. A few minutes later, it was already a 3D model, CAD model in SOLIDWORKS, and later imported in Abacus, tested up to a functional design. So.
Can you share the step file?
Later on, we started working on it. And because we are a Team Rocket, we thought about going to space with it. So we cannot use normal ropes in space, right? We made our own rope. It's made of duct tape. It's a functional design equipped with a super grippy grip called Ultra Grip. And it's got ergonomically shaped handle, the Alpina plastic spoon for putting on shoes was perfect match for our little hands. And yeah, we kind of had to match it with our team name, and we equipped it with a red color and made it like it can work in vacuum. That's all I'm gonna say. This is it from our side, so we can kind of try to pick the objects now. Houston, we have a problem. Ultra grip. We equipped it with a special tooth in the front that's supposed to be super accurate. No, it's super accurate. Mislim, da smo umeni s časom. Like true scientists, sometimes system fails and we have to work around the problems. We tried our best. It's
without the box, how would you normally pick up the paper? Because you use actually the box to...
The paper?
Yeah.
We have this...
Can you show it up?
Yeah.
Can you show it? Show it up.
It's thin and it can go under the paper.
Hvala. Sedaj pa k predstavitvi vabim ekipo Žene Gazele.
Present my team members, Clemen, Rok and Micha, they are all students of mechanical engineering. I myself, I'm Petra and I study computer science. So how did we combine our knowledge of expertise? Well, we made a bionic hand. Of course, the inspiration was human anatomy and we tried to resemble tendon. Of course, humans have two types of tendon in our hands. One is, Rok will present to you how it works. So the first part is in the front, and when you try to squish your hand,
it squishes.
It squishes. and when you want to release it, you use the tendon on the upper part.
On the back.
So the front one is made from awesome Tessa duct tape. We tore it apart and
made it into a rope.
Yes, exactly. And on the back tendon is made from rubber. We tore it apart because it was quite expensive and knitted it into braids. When we tested it, we had some problem with sturdiness. What we did was also try to resemble bones. We took the plywood and Urban, thank you so much for cutting 12 strips of really long plywood. So please give applause for Urban. He was great today. Should we just present how it works? Oh, will you first? I guess we shouldn't be.
Okay, any questions?
Yeah. I think you flew too close to the sun.
Yeah, we were actually.
Zmirali še. Give us your hand. Zdaj pa vabim ekipo GGT.
So, hello everybody, we are team GGT and this is our great grabbing thing. It's mostly made out of duct tape, and inside there are three ropes made of duct tape to control each finger separately. And we have a little bit of plastic here and pieces there, all combined with duct tape. So yeah, that's actually it. we actually have a small fingernail there, but it doesn't seem to work. Anything else?
Thank you.
Okay. Zdaj vabim še predzadnjo ekipo in to je Žilvice 2.0.
So our name is Žilvice, for English customers that would be Turtles 2.0. This is our device, so we went for simplicity and sturdiness because we figured overcomplicating could increase problems during testing and later use. Also we considered applying like a duct tape or a sticky region, but again, during the process when you'd use this a lot, you'd have to replace that a lot, so that could increase the problems and the cost of the operation. So we tried to just keep it simple. And I think we should best just start with the presentation. The design was made to lift heavier objects. We were expecting something a bit larger, heavier, but I guess we also have quite some precision considering that there is a length to it. So yeah, I think we just should just start. Not a problem. There's also a lot of precision, so we can control the grip really nicely. This would also apply for like objects like an egg or something similar. On the other hand, tiny objects like a paperclip prove to be a bit more challenging, but nothing our device cannot tackle. So that's for the paperclip, that somehow got stuck a little. Okay, so you picked it up a little too well, yeah. Okay, so thank you very much. Okay, so yeah, we just went with.
Yeah,
size? Depends on what you're trying to pick up. Another advantage is the versatility, so you can pick up heavier objects closer.
Yeah.
And no problems. Putting it on and off is.
Where did you use all that material which you buy? Here I see you have only 18 tokens left and...
Okay, so the problem was that we didn't trust the plywood. Or the styrofoam. Okay. So we have a lot of bad experience with the styrofoam because after a couple of uses, it generally breaks down. So that was from experience. And with the plywood, we were trying to make a design that would withstand like 10 kilograms or 5 kilograms maybe. So we had to use a lot of wood. So in here we have wood and we have the small wooden sticks. But then we had to put them perpendicular to each other to increase the stability of the system. So if we had to grab something that had like 5 kilograms, this wouldn't bend too much.
Okay, really good.
Okay.
This part that sticks out, why it's so long? The other one, this one.
It's just to it's guide it nicely so it doesn't move left and right.
So it cannot fall out.
So actually when it's fully opened, it's...
Yeah.
We assumed it's going to be
we were prepared for a ball.
Stable even if it's in this position, we didn't want it to...
Can you open it fully with your hand inside?
A long way towards fully opening it, it's this much. Mm. And this is strong enough for me to pull it back.
And yeah, carry something heavy there.
Yeah, we assume it's going to be something large.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Super, hvala. Zdaj pa še zadnja ekipa in to je Beach Boys.
Hello, we're Beach Boys, and this is our handle of positivity. For our design, well, we didn't do the simplicity gig. We went for the complicated thing. We wanted to have a double-jointed finger, and that's what we have, which gave us quite a lot of trouble, if I'm completely honest. We put it together like 3 times and then had to adjust and pick it apart again. As for the sturdiness, as you see, we have a very nice handle here on the arm. All of the weight sits on it here, and even though it's not really that heavy, at least on the other side of the lever. Also, the plywood and the stick is very grippy, so we also tried lifting some heavier objects, and it worked. We also used some wheels, just so we have more moving parts, pretty much. And well, I think that's all that I... I can show you this, how it's operated. My first finger lifts the outermost joint. This one does the thing. And we can also squeeze it really hard by just flexing the whole arm, like this. So that's all of the function right now. And, well, you can time me.
Oh.
Questions?
Are those wheels really necessary?
We found that we haven't really tried without the wheels, but I think they would be necessary to the extent that the wires really flow nicely like this. We could probably use PVC cylinders for that, just to guide them. But it works well with the wheels as well. Now, I don't know if you noticed the detail, but we've actually grinded ways into the wheels so it guides the strings. I'd show it to everyone, but let's not waste time. we did use most of our money. But we got it for free, so.
But the time is money also, so.
True.
No, hvala vsem za predstavitev, meni je bilo ful zanimivo. Zdaj vas pa vabam zunaj na pogostitev, da bo pač ta čas žerija malo predelala, kar ima za predelati, potem pa čez 20 do 30 minut vas sem pa noter poklicala. pripravljeni za videti, kdo so zmagovalci? Ok, cool. Še predtem pa vabim pred mikrofon glavnega organizatorja Urbana Brica.
No, živjo. Mislim, da je vse skupaj kar dobro. Upam, da se strinjate. Pač naloga predstavitve so mi bile tako res zanimive. Ene boljših, kar sem jih videl. Predvsej napeto je bilo zagledati, kako se mučite s temi sponkami. Tako da, res bi pohvalil vse ekipe. Mislim, da je imela žirija res rozno težko delo, ker pač par rešitev mi je bilo tako res neverjetno dobrih. Na tem mestu bi se rad zahvalil še vsem ostalim, pač in žirantom in vsem, ki ste pomagali organizirati. Vsem, ker ste si vzeli čas, da ste prišli sem, predvsem pa organizacijski ekipi. Zdaj, za vami je tako en dan dela, za nami je ene dva meseca dela, tako da je res hvala. Zdaj pa najbolj že zvemo, kdo je zmagal.
Na tej točki zato predajam besedo naši žiriji.
Torej, z dvojnim gripom, petimi prsti in vzmetjo na prstih, 55 cm je v 111 sekundah tretje mesto dosegla ekipa 1. Naslednja ekipa je z najbolj enostavno rešitvijo 80 cm imela malo težav, ampak se je vseeno v 50 sekundah osvojila drugo mesto, Želvice 2.0. Prvo mesto pa si je ekipa z najdaljšo roko, najmanj porabljenega materiala, najboljšo predstavitvijo in najhitrejšim prenosom materialov v 43 sekundah osvojila ekipa Trdoglavci.
Res, ja. 50-50. Lih prav. No, zdaj bi se vas rada zahvalila naši žiriji. Hvala, da ste vzeli čas. In ta namen sem tudi nekaj prinesel, kar se nekaj skriva tukaj, nekaj dobrega. Hvala. Izvolite še vam. Hvala. Zdaj že prej Urban pač povedal, kako pomembna je dobra organizacijska ekipa, tako da bi povabila tudi pomembne člane, pač, ki so veliko prispevali k temu dogodku. Tako da vabim najprej Ajdo. Ona je odgovorna za stike z javnostjo, tako da je bila tista, ki je objavljala cel ta dogodek na Facebook pa na Instagram, tako da hvala. Ok, zdaj vabim Žiketa. On je bil odgovoren za dizajn, pa danes je veliko fotografiral, tako da hvala. No, Dimiter, kako boš to spelo? Dimiter je pa v bistvu se spomnil pač to prednalogo in tudi današnjo nalogo. No. Tako da. Okay. Zdaj še vabim na vodar Tilna. Tilen je poskrbil, da je v bistvu vse potekalo v pravem času in da ste imeli vse, kar, pač, kar ste rabili, tako da je bil logistik. Okay. Zdaj vabim še Petro. Ona je bila v bistvu odgovorna za stike s podjetji, kar je zelo velik pač pomemben del samega dogodka. In seveda še glavna zvezda, to je pa Urban, glavni organizator. Okay, zdaj bi pa jaz v bistvu vas vse prosila, da stopite ven, ker bomo naredili skupno fotografijo. Pa še vabim vas, ker imamo na jutrišnjo zabavo, ki bo ful fajn, na kampusu ob 10. zvečer. Tako da. Za več informacij pa... Ne rabite več informacij, sam kampus ob 10. Aha, pa tukaj le se še postavite po ekipah, da mora res imeli tako pravo ostro sliko vas. Hvala vsem za sodelovanje.